If you've ever been curious about shot peening, what it is, what exactly it's used for, and how it looks whenever you actually do it, we're gonna cover all that today, and we're gonna be using this VH1000 shot blast to do so. Let's get into it. So to explain shot peening, if you are familiar with sandblasting, you've pretty much got the process down. So with shot peening, you are going to be using some sort of metal ball. In this case, we're using stainless steel shot, which you guys can actually see right here. It basically just looks like a small BB. But what you actually do with these is through the force of compressed air, you force these at the part, which it then slams into it and interacts with it. And again, what this does is it's basically like a blacksmith, if you can think about it, who's sitting there repeatedly hitting a part over and over again. So you're causing stress on that surface, but again, you're actually relieving stress. So the easiest way for me to explain that is to actually draw a little bit, which I'm gonna go ahead and apologize because I'm terrible at drawing. Let's say, for example, you're working with a connecting rod, which is what we'll be working with in just a minute. Of course, this is gonna be greatly exaggerated in size, but when you actually cast that connecting rod, there are places on the surface where you form these pockets to stay together, but what happens is there's small portions that actually aren't filled, like this right here. Now, when this connecting rod is being casted and it's hot, that is filled, but when it starts to cool and shrink, those start to separate. So you actually end up with tensile strength right there, and it's trying to pull apart. Now the problem is whenever you actually start to use this part, like again, this connecting rod in a high stress environment, so you're running it at high RPM and whatnot, that's actually where it's going to start to crack. So the reason that you would shot peen this part is again, you're going to go in, you're going to break apart all of those potential places where it would crack in the future and form a more uniform surface. So again, you're just causing plastic deformation to relieve surface tension. That way it won't crack in the future. So you're not exactly hardening the part, but you are strengthening it. So to actually demonstrate, I am gonna be using a connecting rod. This is used, of course, it's coming out of our Ford Mustang V6 motor, but all I wanna demonstrate is how shot peening is actually going to affect the surface of this part. So we should be able to see a pretty good effect. Before I do start, I do wanna mention that I'm gonna be running around 50 PSI when we're actually blasting. So not static, but working pressure will be around 50 PSI. So I'll go ahead and show you guys how this looks, and then we'll actually take it over to our microscope and get you a better up close comparison. I know you can't feel this thing over video, but the surface does actually feel smoother, which is odd to me because we've done some testing with aluminum and it definitely roughs it up. I'll show you that real quick actually. Now, of course, this was done at a higher pressure, but you guys can see, first of all, the deformation that was caused to using the shot blasting machine, but you guys can see just how rough the surface is in comparison to the raw aluminum finish on the back. Even though we were blasting this direction, of course you're increasing the surface area on this side, so you're bowing it that way. With that being said, we'll go ahead and take that part to the microscope and show you guys how it actually looks under some magnification. So guys, as you can see here, we've done a little bit of surface roughness data. One thing that's surprising to me is on the left-hand side, we have the before, and it's actually slightly lower than the after. But again, if you think about it, you are creating a lot more of a profile whenever you're actually shot peening this part. Although it's microscopic, there is more of a profile. One thing that's weird is, especially if you look at the after, it almost looks like it has been sort of rolled. You can actually still see those lines, but I think it did do a good job of smoothing this part. Again, trying to relieve a lot of these lines that you see on the before. If you guys have any questions regarding shot peening, shot blasting, anything like this, please let us know. Again, shot peening is not necessarily a process that you would use for any type of coating removal. If you were looking for something to remove coatings very effectively, you could do a steel grit or something like an engineered abrasive in a pressure pot setup. But again, we're not just limited to this type of data for you guys. We can also look at wet blasting, hydro blasting, any sort of process that you guys are looking for. And we do have a free application testing program. So if you have parts that you would like to validate, either again, wet blasting, sandblasting, shot blasting, whatever it may be, if you would actually like to test it on your parts, we will do that for you for free. If you guys have any questions, you can always call us at 828-202-5563 or check out our website at vaporhauntingtechnologies.com. If you have any other questions, leave it in the comments below. Thank you all for watching and have a great day. Peace.